tell, but you can bet I'm prepared for anything. And that's no lie, spotlight's on you, so you know it's showtime.
My place to scold him. Never told him nothing wrong. Kept it fair. Didn't listen, so I might as well have been talking to the air. Everybody makes mistakes. A mistake is aight. But if it ain't, I'ma tell you straight. Time to say goodnight. Nobody likes to be played, regardless of the relationship. But shorty's fucking up big time. I hate this shit. I'm caught in the middle of having love for a little nigga. No one was expected of me as a real nigga. My next move is crucial. What do I do? How do I keep it real with shorty and my crew? Didn't want to kill him, so instead of putting a Mac on him, I did the only thing I could do, turn my back on him.
Here we go again, same old shit dog, it's a different day. Here we go again, you know how niggas do when we play, how we play. Here we go again, a man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. Here we go again, what this fuck me nigga, no it's fuck you.
Niggas that I fuck with, wanna get him dead, but I'm cool with shorty's people. So I let him live. Under normal circumstances, he would be a marked man. But I hit him with a grand, just didn't shake his hand. Go about your business, do what you gon' do. Be what you gon' be, I wash my hands, I'm through. I can forgive, I just can't forget. You're on your own, low man, don't ask me for shit. If you paid attention to what I taught you, then you good. If I see you again, get it, understood? Your head before I change my mind, cause you know you should be dead. I just wanna say, ah, get ahead. Instinct told me to kill him, but the savior is I'm a good nigga, plus I owe his peeps a favor. But I also knew the decision I just made went against the rules of the game that we play.
Here we go again, same old shit though, it's a different day. Here we go again, you know how niggas do when we play, how we play. Here we go again, the man's gonna do what a man's gonna do. Here we go again.
I should've followed my first instinct, cause I knew sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. Now this nigga's fucking with the competition. Ungrateful motherfucker, should've got a miss. This nigga got the nerve to take my kindness for a weakness. Gots to get back on some street shit so I can creep this rat. When I act, take one, set him up, take two, get him there, take three, get him done. Was it hard for me to get him where I wanted him, confronted him, click. There was a bullet in one of them. Feeling lucky? Click. Looks like you are. Click, click, click. Luck ain't going too far. What you did was put on another pair of shoes and it just happened to be too big. What you did was stupid. Real fucking stupid. Yo, shorty, I gave you a chance. What did you do? Threw it back in my fucking face, so fuck you too.
Here we go again. Same old shit, dog. It's a different day. Here we go again. You know how niggas do when we play, how we play. Here we go again. A different day. Here we go again. Yeah. Man, we do when we play how we play. Here we go again. Yeah. Man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. Here we go again. So if it's fuck me, nigga, you know it. as fuck you.
Alrighty, alright then. If you know as fuck me, then you know as fuck you. That's right, I waited for a little while. Little DMX in the background. Y'all see the title. I'm gonna cut straight to the chase. Angryman, what the fuck? Nigga, what is you talking about? Just get real. Everybody like to dance around, wait for the cash apps to flow. No, I'm gonna cut to the chase. Nigga, you should not be giving anybody advice anywhere. I'm gonna do a little series on you. This here is just part one. I don't know what made me choose you or all of these so-called internet gurus. I could have talked about Kevin Samuels. I could have talked about BGS. I could have talked about who else calls themselves the prophet of truth, whatever it is. I could have talked about all these so-called internet gurus that's out there giving advice night after night. I'm speaking of night after night, my man. How many times a day do you stream? Do you have any fucking home life? There is no way in God's green earth that you can tell me that your home life is up to par. When I see you, I don't know how the hell you end up in my algorithms, but you're always there streaming 3-4 times a day for hours. A cat that's a six-figure nigga, as you claim to be, don't do that, bro. You gotta have other business outside of YouTube. But it's obvious that you don't. That's why you're such an easy target. I don't understand how your folks, how your fans, how your loyal subjects, how your minions continue to let you just repeat the things that you say over and over. You say something one year. One year, you don't want no ladies around you. The next year, we see you up on panels with ladies like Raw B. Am I wrong? One year, you're calling women strags. The next year, you up on a panel hosting a tea party. Come on, bro, which is it? Here we go again. Same old shit, dog, just another day. You've been doing this since 2018. I've compiled information on you from 2018. I'm not trolling you. And you will probably say, well, you must be a fan of mine for this, for you to be getting. No, people are sending me this content. People are sending me this. It's ending up at this. You are the talk of the bullshit town. Not the talk of the town. You are the talk of the bullshit. What is Angry Man doing today? Oh, he over there telling you the real reason why. The real reason why Kwame Brown didn't do this. The real reason why Will slapped Chris Rock. The real reason why Jada did this. You always got a real reason for something. Well, here's the real reason why you got to stream, because you must need some cash. And for you, the quickest way to do it is to sit on a YouTube stream and talk about nothing. No substance. No, you have absolutely no substance. You are basically a, dare I use the word charlatan. You are a YouTube version, a low-budget YouTube version of the Jerry Springer Show. Even so more, I'll see me so much, not even the Jerry Springer, the Steve Wilco Show. You'll always be the backup to the backup. Kevin Samuels came on the scene, blew you out the water. As much as I don't agree with BGS's content, every time I see him on the stream, he's blowing you out the water. Fresh and Fit, you tried to get on their podcast, and then you when they obvious these folks and say, shit, who the fuck is this Angry Man? How the hell would we let him on there? You don't talk about them no more, do you? You went over to Ank T's channel, hollering about Ank T this, Ank T that, talking about the first time you came over to Ank T's channel. As a matter of fact, I got a clip on that. I don't know how you pronounce his name, but he speaks about your hypocrisy, my man. So let's get to that first, all right? Check this out. Of course, the person that sent me this didn't want their business put out there. But again, as you can see, this information is coming to me, okay? I'm not seeking it out, so let's get it.
Your YouTube channel, for the moment while you live, it's taking over your goddamn channel, man. That's all that nigga Angry Man's doing. He playing stream yards on these goddamn niggas, dog. That's what he's trying to do. While he's here, since he's the Angry Man, bro, all right, everybody, nigga, no matter who the channel holder is, right? Give up, nigga, give up your channel to Angryman for however many hours he might be here until he leave and shit. So let him control, right, your channel. Man, let me keep playing this weak ass shit. Hold up.
Can y'all do that? So if he's like, yo, chill out for a second, and y'all just keep going like on some fuck ante type shit, can y'all at least have some respect for the man's platform? Hello?
I believe that I've had some respect for Ante's panel.
I'm out.
I believe I've been very respectful of his panel.
I can't be respectful.
So why are you? The only way you can be here, Miss Sheila, is if you cursing somebody out.
No, because I have been here and I was talking before. I was cursing me and a couple of guys. We were talking about panels and our channels and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But like I said, there's a lot of favoritism around here.
I was there favoritism. Like who's favoring who?
There's a lot of favoritism. There's a lot of jumping on people, putting people in the back pass so other ones are talking all that
bullcrap. That's not favoritism. This is why what you're doing right now is order. That's why.
There you go. What this is the reason why shit. This is the reason why. And Rue is absolutely right. This is what you do, my man. You go over to other folks' panel and you take it over. You try and, as we call it in the music industry, in the DJ business, in the radio business, you try to pinch other people's subs. You try to go over there and you sit there long enough, and sooner or later, you hoping that the host, in this case, Aunt T, builds you up enough to where he'll allow you to put your link down in his chat space. And next thing you know, you got more followers. What I don't get is, this is the question I got for the ladies that listen to you, Raw Bees, and all the other ladies in your chat room. Raw B, you seem to be quite an intelligent young woman. I don't understand. No disrespect to you, but I know there was a stream that I literally heard Angryman call you a bitch. Literally. Now you teaming up with him. And what my man Rue is doing is he's addressing exactly what a whole lot of y'all is just willing to not even acknowledge. The fuck? I got no beef with Taz Exclusives, and he got his own thing going over there. But, you know, you got to look at it like this. Whether you agree or disagree with Taz Exclusives' content, at least he does decent content from time to time. Yeah, he might be in a lot of shit show wars over there. Right now, he currently in one with some chick named Black Womansphere, and that's another motherfucker I'm going to get on. Currently, he over there entangled with that bullshit. That's a lot of thing about these internet friendships. That's why I kind of keep my distance. I keep a small group of internet friends around me, just like I do on the outside. I keep a small group of people around me. And even in that small group of people, I only put them on a need-to-know basis. And you can ask any of them that, and any of those that are listening, bro, they know exactly what I'm talking about. But you guys get in these back chats, in these back streams, passing pictures, passing notes to each other, recording each other, not thinking sooner or later somebody gonna use this shit against you. That's why I don't do it. Angryman, there's some shit floating around with you screaming at your children. You screaming at your chick. Come on, man. But let's get back to Rue addressing that shit. You are coming in folks' panels. Because you do. You a channel hopper. You are, as somebody eloquently called you, you is a panel whore.
That's why you got pulled down, because when we was like, yo, chill out for a second, you was the only one that didn't stop talking. It ain't favoritism. You're just trying to bring order to the panel. And y'all are sitting there cursing each other the fuck out. Like, just going the fuck in. And it's like, yo, chill the fuck out. And see, here's the funny thing. A lot of y'all are in these spaces, and a lot of y'all complain about the fact that men be saying this and men be saying that, but then y'all get on panels and do this shit. They don't care. It's like,
I have an issue. No, I don't care. You keep saying y'all. I haven't called anyone out. I haven't called anyone out of their names. I've let her purge. I let her say what she wanted to say.
Don't say no purge. And see, y'all seen the Bible talk about the sick talking woman. See, the witch.
See, you got people in the chat room. This is my point. You got people in the chat room talking about I'm bored now. I'm leaving. Because that's what they come here for. They come here to watch niggas act ignorant as fuck.
Well, this is the thing, Miss Cena. Is that hypocrisy right there, man?
Or is that double talk? What you call that, right? Because, I mean, when, ain't this the same nigga that was coming to the purge last week? To see niggas act a damn fool? And was he contributing to the purge? Yeah, as a matter of fact, the nigga won the purge, right? Was he the MVP of the purge?
You damn Skippy, he was. That motherfucker came in there, turned into the Angryman, macho savage. You can't handle this, boy. You can't do this, boy. You can't handle me, boy. I'm the king of the purge, boy. You damn Skippy, he was in there, Root. Loud and clear. That nigga fell out the clouds every time he thought somebody was upshining him. So much so that this cat was monitoring the polls to see whether he was winning or not. And when he got behind, he called foul. I cashed App Ant and told him, and Ant, you Ant T can verify this, let Angryman hold his own nuts. Ant T can verify that. Ask Ant T if he did not get a Cash App from Stevie Music saying, let Angryman hold his own nuts during that purge. Because he was always coming there talking about who winning, who ahead. Me personally, I could have got up there. Yeah, shit, not my thing. There's a whole lot of folks that was welcome to jump up on the purge. But Angryman made sure that every day during the purge that he was on it, morning, noon, and night. Which goes back to my saying, if you ain't streaming on your channel, you're hopping on somebody else's panel. What kind of fucking family life do you have? I know one damn thing for sure. If I was married, my man, or if I was living with a woman, ain't no way in hell that there wouldn't be some dissension in the house, that every time my chick turned around, I was on a live stream yelling at people. Come on now. And you call yourself a relationship expert, giving relationship advice. We're going to get to that a little bit later on too. But first, let me let my man Rue finish ripping you up a little bit. Come on, Bob.
Because he was doing most of the damn fooling around, bro, on the perch. This nigga, he didn't boycott the purge. Hold on, nigga, time out, bro. You was the MVP of the purge. You popped up every goddamn time. You had a chance to pop up, nigga, going at it with everybody on some clown shit, on some goofy ass shit. But nigga, you was being a damn fool. You was acting a fool, right? I'm trying to make sure I'm hearing this shit right, man. Hold on.
That's what they come here for. They come here to watch niggas act ignorant as fuck.
To watch niggas act ignorant as fuck. Nigga, we was acting ignorant in a motherfucker the last week, bro. We was acting ignorant, nigga. Ignorant in a bitch, nigga. Last week. And you was damn sure in it. Why in the fuck, man? This nigga Angryman didn't tell Auntie, look, bro, I don't want to do this shit. I don't want to see black people purging black people. Now, if you had some white folks up here or some Mexicans, nigga, then I'm all in it. But, nigga, I don't want to come up here purging the same people I've been knowing in the space for years. I don't want to even be roasting a nigga. I don't want to act ignorant as fuck on your shit.
And that is a legitimate question, Angryman. Can you answer that? Because a few minutes ago, you were speaking peace and harmony. But you turned out to be the MVP of the purge. So that means you had to talk a whole lot of shit. You had to be currently, you had to be an argument with a whole lot of people. You just couldn't choose one. You had to argue with girls. You had to argue with men. You had to argue with everybody, bro. To be the MVP, I mean, I have to be quite honest with you. I found it quite entertaining. And when I heard you up there against some folks, they roasted you. I forgot who the guy's name. Maybe it was the TVA or something like that. Or I forgot who it was. He ripped you a new asshole. He certainly did. But because you had your minions coming over there rooting for you, you won the MVP. You went to a live stream. You told them, hey, y'all need to get over there and make sure you vote for your boy. Make sure you go join the purge and vote for your boy. I'm cooking over there. We're going to get to that here right after my man Root finish, where you consider yourself cooking. You done, man? You done? Okay. All right. Seems like I got some more clips with my man Root talking about you. I'm just going to use that one right now to make a point. Like I said, I'm going to do a little series of talks on you. Listen, first and foremost, I have nothing to hide. So you can consider yourself doxing me all you want to. I don't claim to be a six-figure nigga. I don't claim to be married. I don't claim to own millions of dollars in property and all that. I'm just a simple man, but a radio station doing my thing. And I won't even use the word simple man. I don't create no waves out here for nobody. I do my own thing. I'm a lone wolf. I don't beat on women. I don't have no criminal record. So to look up for something on me, first of all, yeah, you got to figure out where I'm from and where I'm at. And if you're willing to do all of that, then maybe. But anyway, that's another whole nother story. That's what I don't get about this doxing shit. It's not doxing when you folks put your information out there and somebody just go to Facebook or Instagram and pull it up. It's not doxing you. But anyway, let's get on to some more of the Angryman here. But you know what? Before we do that, I heard lovely Peace's voice. On that stream right here, and I gotta say, she has a very unique voice about her, so much so that I asked her to do a voiceover for me for my radio station. So you guys take a listen to a lovely piece, a radio drop.
Hi, this is Lovely. You're listening to your nighttime right time DJ. DJ Music on CRBJ's Classic R&B Jams Radio. Soulful sounds all around town.
Shout out to Jay the Legend. He said KS made 4.5 million off your talking points. Good for him. Good for him. Good for him. I made let me do the math real quick.
I talked about this before. What nigga in his right mind that has $1 million in his account can sit down in front of a live stream with a calculator and figure out his net worth? What motherfucker in his right mind that has some business savvy would know that this nigga is perpetrating a fraud right now? They always say fake it till you make it. You can't fake this bullshit. You can't fake, you cannot bullshit a bullshitter. I'm trying to recognize this shit. What you adding up right now? What's it, lunch money? How much you spent last week on groceries? Because there's no way you can tell me that you got $1 million sitting in the bank and you can pull up where it came from. But, you know, this is just his way of stalling. You figured it out yet? Hmm? You got that?
Yeah.
Well, how much is it? How much you got?
I made about 1.2 off of my talking points.
What talking points? What talking points do you have, Angryman? What talking points, brother, do you have? What educational benefit is it to anyone, any man or woman that comes over to your channel and listens to you? The King of the Purge. What talking points? A little on a stream that you was doing last night talking about men. Well, how do you train boys to men and stuff like that? That's a song too. I might even throw that at you a little bit later on. But anyway, what talking points? You broke out into a joke session, a roast session about women, because that's what you normally do. You started bragging about your success rate for women was 98%, where some dudes would expect the coochie. You didn't fluff for it. Nigga, ain't nobody with the 98% success rate. Ain't no man on earth, not unless he buying it at a whole house, got a 98% success rate. Hell no. You ain't gonna tell me 98% of the time you went after a woman, you struck gold. Get the fuck out of here. Alright, you tell me that shit. That's saying that. And 98% of the women that you run into or find you attractive, Angryman. Imagine that now. Be careful what you say around some folks. But anyway, let's continue. And
there's a problem when you gotta take certain individuals seriously. That's a problem. Right? And what I said earlier is the damn truth. All this shit was a distraction. All it was a way to put the onus back on the behavior of black men and take the freaking attention off of the negativity of the B-dub. That's what that was. That's what that was. You know the reason why in this space you look around and it's women in here that are chilling and acting like they're all good and they're all cool? You know the reason why? It's because the Angryman fell back. The Angryman stopped cooking. And the moment the Angryman stopped cooking, they said, oh, we home free now. Ain't no need of us going hard in the paint.
For all of you ladies that have run across my channel, do you understand what he just said? Rob B, if you ever listen to me, if you come on over, tune in. I'm going to highlight your name in this. This is what you're dealing with. As even Kendra D, I don't like any of her content. But this is what you're dealing with. He stopped cooking, but so you women can, now that he stopped cooking, basically what he's saying is now that he stopped roasting you women, y'all can come into the space and feel comfortable. Wait a minute. So you did make sure I'm not double talking. Let's hear it again.
Activity of the B-dub. That's what that was. That's what that was. You know the reason why in this space you look around and it's women in here that are chilling and acting like they're all good and they're all cool? You know the reason why? It's because the Angryman fell back. The Angryman stopped cooking.
The
Angryman stopped cooking, they said, oh, we home free now. Ain't no need of us going hard in the paint. But I promise you, if I start calling shit out again, you gonna watch these women change up. You gonna watch them start going ham. You gonna watch them start attacking. You gonna watch them start tripping, because I can pull the SCRAGG out of them.
You understand that, ladies? The only reason you, as according to the Angryman, I'm going to channel my inner GMT. This Negro says, if it had not been for the angry man, y'all know how he leaned back in the seat a little bit. The BW will not be comfortable in these spaces. The angry man. But you understand what he's saying, ladies, Raw Bees, and the rest of you ladies that get up on these panels with him. The only reason you are acting as according to him civilized is because he hasn't decided to go at you and pull out your inner SCRAGG that all women have. It's just a matter of pulling it out of you. It's just a matter of pushing the right button. But earlier you heard him clearly. See, that's what I'm saying. Just because he has on a different shirt, that don't mean he's a different person. He's still the same guy. I say this in every stream that I say this about these folks. Leopards do not change their spots no matter what part of the jungle they move to. He can try and disguise it with the New York hat, but he's still who he is. He can try and disguise it with the backdrops, but he still, sooner or later, when he opens up his mouth, sooner or later, we all know that he is the angry man. And it's just a matter of time before the real angry man shows up in any given situation, screaming at somebody to catch a flight. Your reputation precedes you everywhere you go. So much so that folks jump off panels when you come up. So Rue was absolutely right about what he said. You go where the action is at, hoping you can pinch off some of their rise to fame. You killed DJ Kuda's stream. Now you went over there to AT, and you're pretty much doing the same thing over there. You don't want to see nobody outshine the angry man. So I'll ask you again, angry man, what content are you putting out? What are you doing to educate the neighborhood, the boys, as you say in your moniker on your website, your creed? I got a whole lot more shit to call about your hypocrisy. We're just starting here today. See, you can't go to my channel and say I'm being hypocritical about anything, because I call it square down the middle. I'm just like the 6 o'clock news reporter. I have no skin in this game. I don't ask nobody for those super chats. I don't ask folks doing the stream, hey, I'm not going to give you any more information. I need 20 more subscribers. I need 20 more donations before I go any further, or I'm going to cut the stream. No, I get on, pass my information, and I move on about my business. Like the grocery store, angry man. Put it on the shelf. Take up what you need. Leave the rest there for somebody else to get. That's how you help the community. Now, is there something wrong with you? Because everybody, I would imagine everybody does this YouTube shit to become, you know, to become, I won't say famous, but, you know, to make a little money off of it, or to have a voice. Whatever the motivation is, somewhere along the line, you went completely wrong. From the days that I met you back when I was first, when I called into your show, to now, ain't no fucking way. No way you're going to tell me that you got content, bro. What is it? Give me a stream. Give me a stream to look at the word. You're talking about anything of any of substance. Give me a stream. Send it to me. And I'll report on it. I surely will. But let's go.
The reason why they're not tripping now, because the mother dudes are weak. That's how chicks like Jessica X and Sister George, and don't get it twisted, I ain't got shit against them. They're only doing what y'all are allowing them to do. Right? But that's how they can come into these spaces and not only have a platform, but make you niggas work for them in their platform. That's the reason why they're chill. That's the reason why they're laid back, because you niggas ain't a threat. You niggas ain't a problem. You don't challenge their ideology. You don't challenge the shit that they say.
What would be the purpose in that, angry man? What would be the purpose to go up on someone's panel just to challenge their ideology? Everyone has a right to their beliefs. Now, whether you disagree or agree with it, that's particularly up to you. That's why people have these panels. That's why possibly I'm having this conversation right now, because I don't agree with a lot of things that you're saying. I'm not challenging your ideology. I'm not challenging your beliefs. I'm challenging the words that you are using. As you call it, your intellectual property, and it is not. What about what you're saying right now has any intellectual value? Please tell me. Please inform the masses. What have we listened to so far in these last two clips? And you're saying, you guys are just going to my streams and cherry picking. No, this is any given stream, like any given Sunday. This is any given stream. You don't have to cherry pick. This is any given stream.
You niggas is awesome. Oh, we can't beat them, so let's join them bullshit. He never gonna come over here and see a woman running my channel. Never. It'll never fucking happen.
Ooh, nigga, didn't I just see you on a panel with Rob B the other day? Ooh, nigga, didn't I just see you on a panel with four or five other niggas and you was the one that was quiet? Didn't I see you sipping tea with somebody else? It's not a matter of running your channel. And let me give you a little bit of benefit of advice. Maybe you've heard this before, but I'll say it to you again, brother man. 10,000 hours. Try that. And along with that 10,000 hours, understand, in this business, whether you like it or not, any professional in this business, whether it be radio, TV, or advertising, on either one of those platforms, will tell you that women run this business. Whether it be through the advertisements that you see, like when you go to the grocery store and you see one of the Budweiser girls in a slink bikini with Budweiser wrapped around her, or the sexy voice that you hear in the commercial telling you where to turn to or whatever. You understand what I'm saying? Women run this. And any professional in this business says, if you want to be successful at creating podcasts, you have to include women in that business, either as a part of or catering to. There is no way my radio station would be where it's at right now if I played music just to cater to men. You are out of your damn skull.
Not in a million motherfucking years. Right? Right? But that's what you see going on. That's what you see going on. I heard a clip that somebody played and they wouldn't give me the clip. You know what Obsidian said on the show? He said, hey, ladies, I'm pretty sure y'all would agree with me that there's a lot of fine niggas out here. He literally said that out of his mouth. If anybody has that clip, I need you to send it to me. Because Clue was supposed to send it to me, but he on some bullshit. I asked that nigga three fucking times, send me the clip. He said, I'm gonna send you the clip. Gave him my email address. But see, grown men don't do what they say they gonna do.
And nowadays. And this is a guy searching for content, ladies and gentlemen, to get a clip sent to him so he can talk shit about another man. This is a guy that does his own research. No. Angryman, you really don't know how much shit I really do know about you, brother. If it had not been from some behind the scenes people helping you out, you would not be where you are right now. Those very same people that you said at one time that you missed, if those folks had not been in your corner back in the day in those discords with you, you know who I'm talking about. There's no sense in mentioning them. But if they hadn't been back there cheering you on, building you up, you would not be who you are. But just like with anybody, as soon as they started coming up or as soon as they started challenging some of the things that they wanted to do, you shit on them. You did it with Sheet Stay Sleep. You did it with Kendra D. I don't know if DS1 is the same guy. You did it with the Grinch, but Grinch still hang around you like you got some kind of hold on him. Grinch, I don't understand you. I don't listen to your content. But what is it about this man that you can't see for yourself? This is a motherfucker that I don't need to be around. I've heard you allude to it a few times. Are you worried about if you stop hanging around Angryman, so will his subscribers, so will his subs? I think that's the point. And if I keep listening to you, because you're on a lot of Angryman's panels, you might be ending up on one of these shows. And you don't want to do that. Alright? You don't want to do that. I noticed that one time I was on a panel and you called me up about something. You said something to me about something. So don't do that, Bo. You don't want to do that. I'm thorough, all right? And it ain't about you, nothing about you personally that I'll ever talk about. I'll just use the words that you have on YouTube. I'm thorough with it, bro. Better look up the wordsmith, all right? Don't do that. Don't do it to yourself. You better let Angryman hold his own nuts here, all right?
They like to play a lot of fucking games.
Do your own shit, nigga.
It's not like a tangible item. In other words, if Kevin goes and he makes $100,000 off of a particular talking point or a particular idea, doesn't mean I can't go and make the same $100,000 off of that same idea, that same talking point.
Now here it is here again. Earlier you heard him talking about he made $1.4 million off of his talking points, right? But now he's trying to nigga explain why Kevin didn't do as good as why Kevin is doing what as good as or better than him. Now that shit ate him up so much that he had to go back later on and explain to the audience why Kevin is making more money than him. Here it is, because Kevin is marketable, whether you like him or not. He is marketable. You are not. You're a 40-something-year-old dude sitting on a stream 4 or 5 times a day with 20-year-old men's clothing on. You dye in your beard. One day it's red. The next day it's gray. The next day it's black. Check your eye. See your eye. See, look at your eyeglasses. Your eyeglasses tell us exactly where you're at. There's some things that you can't hide, no matter how hard you try. Just based on the reflections and refractions. Your eyes, the reflection in your eyeglasses tell me that you are sitting in front of a computer. And everything behind you is blank. If it had not been for the green screen that you created and you paid your subscribers paid for, we would see part of your house. Anybody, any fool will tell you that. Well, it probably would be your garage. That's probably where you're at. But anyway, that's nitpicking. But that just goes to show you, if somebody really wanted to be that petty, the petty God might fall on me at any time and look for him. Sir Petty. He ain't around. But that was being petty. So let's get back to it.
Okay. So him making four, whatever you said, 4.5 million, him making that doesn't take away from me. Doesn't take away from what I made. Right? Doesn't take away.
Nigga, tell us something we don't know. That's like me and another dude. That's like me being in the military. And me and him, both of us is sergeants. He get a paycheck and I get a paycheck. Because we both are sergeants, we get the same paycheck in the military. But now let's translate to the civilian world. Just because he's a supervisor here and I'm a supervisor here, that doesn't translate to the same rate of pay. They might be paying me more for my experience. They might be paying him more for his experience or her experience. Me personally, I never talk money with anybody. You don't need to know how much I got. You don't know where I'm getting it from. And don't ask me for none. The fuck? What are you talking about? Why are you in Kevin Samuels' pocket right now? Why are you worried about what he does and how he does instead of, you're absolutely right, concentrating on good content? It eats you up that somebody, one of your loyal subjects, questioned you, didn't it? Because you don't let anybody who just randomly talk in your chat room. That's somebody who comes to your chat room. That's somebody's paid either to subscribe to you, bought a subscription, or something. Alright?
Away from what I made. Because see, here's the thing. This is what you got to realize. And y'all never understood this, no matter how many ways I explain it. I don't have a problem with him using the talking points. They're talking points. I have a problem with him using it without giving me credit. Now, let's back up for a second. Technically, he didn't make 1.4, 1.5 million off of my talking points. He made 1.5 million off of his hard work. Okay? Okay? He made 1.5 million off of his hard work. That's what he made it off of. All right. It's not like he used a shell of my body and went up there as a version of me and made the money that I could have made. I couldn't have made that money in that space because I don't have that many subscribers. So I'm not mad about that. He's supposed to make that kind of money. In fact, I would argue that he's supposed to make more than that. I would argue that he's supposed to make more than that.
See, that's what I'm saying. See, that's what I'm saying. Everything comes full circle. And this is what this whole conversation was about. I would argue that he should make more than that. Again, why are you in that man's pockets? What would be the argument? What about his Kevin Samuels, ready if he not unless he opened up his books to you and show you what he did and how he did it and why he did it? What would be your argument? You would have to literally be in his corner to put up an argument that said which contradicts everything that you said about Kevin Samuels. You would literally have to go to the people and say, wait a minute, this man is, well, according to what I make, and from what I see of Kevin Samuels, he should be making more. You guys need to pay him accordingly. Since you just said it's off his hard work. Which is it, Angry Man? Or is you is, or is you ain't his baby? Which one is it? Because from back in the day, Kevin Samuels was your boy. Sure was. As a matter of fact, let me stop this, and I'm gonna pull up something else. Hold on just a second. Hold on just a damn minute. All right. Hold up. Yeah. Hey, Rue, do me a favor. Holler at me for a sec.
He just pretty much was on some Rue is tripping. That nigga Rue Dell, nigga Rue Dell, this and that. Everybody don't fuck with that nigga Rue Dell. Rue Dell on some bullshit. Protect Kevin Samuels at all costs, right? Y'all was on that shit 2018, 2019, when I was on Kevin Samuels' ass saying, look, bro, get your faggot ass the fuck up out of here, nigga. I got on B1 channel, nigga. I got on Taz shit or Nala shit. I said, look, the issue is, nigga, you, Kevin Samuels is a whole fag bag, and you niggas acting like y'all don't see this shit. Why y'all letting this faggot ass, punk ass nigga have any say so in this shit, bro? What the fuck y'all niggas are doing? And I wasn't even trying to be disrespectful, even though I was coming from a perspective of, nigga, you niggas saying that y'all niggas are anti gay shit. You niggas are saying, this is what you niggas are saying, that you niggas are anti homosexuality, anti niggas in wigs and lipstick and makeup and dresses. You anti all that shit. But y'all clearly see this nigga here on Instagram wearing man bags and shit, feathers with shoes with feathers on it. You see this nigga wearing fucking jeans with the knees cut out and all that kind of shit, right? And you niggas acting like it's okay. Cause y'all think what, man? Y'all think that because BGS Idmore and them and O'Shea Du Jackson co-signed the nigga, then he's all right? You don't see this bitch ass nigga for what he is? I've seen him, everybody co-signed the nigga, right? But look at you niggas now, though. So I didn't come to you asking you to fix a bitch ass thing, though, nigga. So come again, nigga. Like, hold up. Let's keep praying. Listen to this shit.
There you go.
No. I'm trying to see. Hold on. All the time. I'm talking about. When you ever ask you to fix anything on some KS? If anything, nigga, I was telling you. What's up?
Came to my channel.
Yo.
And give me a whole speech about how you came to me back in the day saying that I needed to denounce Kevin and I need to do this and I need to do that, and I hit you, and that's how it got to where it got to. And I said, you know what? You're right. You don't remember that conversation?
No, I told you about somebody that's got an echo up here, man. That's by you, buddy. You got an echo by you. Buddy, you got an echo.
It's going.
What happened when I came to you, on behalf of that whole Kevin Samuels situation was because you guys was putting Kevin Samuels above other guys, right? And he was a straight up homosexual. And you also came to you about the Kendra D, when Kendra D mentioned that she was comfortably seated in the Black Manosphere. So I came to you and I'm like, bro, is this okay with you guys? Because this is the type of shit you guys running. And so I didn't come to you to ask you to solve nothing, though. I just want you to address how you guys are co-signing some shit that you normally wouldn't co-sign. That's what I said.
But yeah, my brother.
And again, Rue is absolutely right. Which is it? At one point in time, in 2018, as reliable sources tell me, receipts they have that says you and Kevin Samuels were, dare I say, friends at one time or the other. You and O'Shea Duke Jackson were friends at one time or the other. You and Obsidian were friends at one time or the other. You and BGS were friends at one time or the other. You and Cerulean Gray was friends at one time or the other. You and Kendra D was friends at one time or the other. You and Sheet Stay Sleep was friends at one time or the other. What's the common denominator? You ain't friends with none of them no more. You ain't friends with none of them no more. Now here it is, 2018, 2019, like Rue said, you was championing for Kevin Samuels. 2020, 2021, Kevin Samuels go viral. All of a sudden, he's stealing your talking points. Now, Kevin Samuels should give you credit. So that leads credibility to what I'm talking about. I didn't invent this conversation. I had no idea of what you and Kevin Samuels was doing in 2018, because I wasn't around you in 2018. I wasn't in the YouTube streets like this in 2018. Or if I came to YouTube, it was for music. It wasn't to run look at the Angryman gossip show. But wait a minute. Let's listen to this again. Hold on a sec.
Version of me and made the money that I could have made. I couldn't have made that money in that space because I don't have that many subscribers. So I'm not mad about that. He's supposed to make that kind of money. In fact, I would argue that he's supposed to make more than that. I would argue that he's supposed to make more than that. Okay? Because I've made a fourth of that. And I damn sure ain't got no million subs. You understand? So, y'all gotta chill with that. Look, I don't care that Kevin is successful. Run interference. So it's like, you got female hyenas over here doing whatever, and the lions are paying attention to the female hyenas. So the female hyenas, they'll send out two of the male hyenas to go get into a fight over there. That's so the lions will look over there and not pay attention to what the female hyenas are doing.
Let me ask you, Aru, would you agree with that? I don't think so, because this is behind the scenes. There is no females involved in this. Wait a minute, Rue.
You gotta look at the way how we see it because the way you coming off is kind of.
Hey, hold up, chop it up. They got history. Let them talk. Stay out of it, man. Stay out of it, bro.
Yes, sir. Here's the thing. And I get what you're saying, Rue. Normally, when two chicks get into it, you leave it the fuck alone. But
yeah, exactly.
Two chicks, but that's in regular life. We're on a panel that's a dude's panel. And if we just sit up here and let two chicks go at it, guess what? Dudes is going to say, y'all niggas ain't got no control over your panels and shit. Right or wrong?
But this is not your panel. This is Auntie's panel. And Auntie's more than capable of controlling his shit.
Yeah, I mean, hey, I tried to drop people down and shit like that. I appreciate both of you.
No, I agree, Auntie. What I'm saying, Angryman don't need to come over here trying to control your shit. Nigga, you more than capable of running your own shit like you've been doing.
If it was obvious how I was trying to control it without having to flush nobody off this motherfucker. So see, maybe they ain't want to listen to me. Maybe they listen to him. Maybe they ain't want to listen to me or him. Maybe they listen to you. That's why I let y'all up here. I thought maybe Raw B would be able to. That's why I just left Raw B up here with the two of them. And it wasn't working. So
This shit been going on for months. These women got history. They done came to my channel with it, right? I just let them go ahead and do their thing because it's like, okay, I can't stop it. It's bigger than me. No matter how much of a...
And again, he's absolutely right. Instead of up there trying to regulate what these women do, let them do what they do. I don't go up. When Bomb Cherry is roasting a female on her panel, I don't get up on the panel. I got nothing to do with it. When Miss Sheila come over to... When her and the beach was having their little spiff, I didn't go up on the panel. I didn't choose sides. I like both of these women. I like Bomb Cherry. I enjoy their content for what it is. I don't go there and expect anything other than what they talk about. They don't advertise the big uppers of the young black male. That's not what they're there for. That's not about their channel. Their channel was more like a community center. Everybody come in. Everybody has a different throw at what's to be spoken on or what's spoken about. And not necessarily some interest that where a man should speak on it. On a rare occasion, I will go on one of these particular ladies' panels. I don't panel hop from channel to channel. And if I do, I'm listening to the content creator. I didn't come there to be a part of the show like you, Angryman. But Rue called it. But it's going to get worse. Like I said, I have a series of things on you and about you. No, I'm not singling you out. I'm just pointing you out.
A voice I may have, nigga, motherfucker. I might be a nigga who can talk real tough, nigga. But yeah, these women going at it, nigga. I'm good on it. I ain't trying to be tough in this particular situation. The shit not gonna resolve right now anyway.
This one, bro, number one, first and foremost, let me address what you just said. Number one, I didn't come over here to control Auntie's channel.
That's what you're trying to do, nigga.
No, it's not. What you're trying to do is start shit.
I'm not trying to start no shit, nigga. I'm here. You've been doing this, nigga. Hold on, you do this everywhere you go, man. You come in acting like as if you give a fuck about the sake and the health and the actual channel. You come in trying to run this shit. Bro. That's what you're doing.
Wait a minute, Sheila. First of all, Rude, just because you got a chip on your shoulder about me,
I don't got no chip on the shoulder about you. I'm just dressing you for what the fuck you're doing right now, nigga.
Right. Let me ask you that. That's a good question. Why is it, Angryman, that every time somebody address you about something, they have to have their chip on their shoulder about you? Why somebody have to be mad at you or have something personally against you to address your bullshit? If that's the case, everybody gonna have a chip on their shoulder. Because Rue is not the only one that thinks this way. I think this way. A whole lot of people think this way. If you go back to this particular stream, you will see that Rue and I are not the only people that agree with what he's saying right now. Of the hundreds of people was in the chat room that night, I would venture to say 80% of them agreed with Rue, not with you. And here it is, you talking about last night, you talking about respect for women, and women can sense out bullshit, and women can sense out fuckery. You don't think Miss Sheila or Lovely Peace could sense out the fuckery in you? Huh? Knick knack, give a dog a bone.
I'm just telling you to fall the fuck back right now, nigga. It's not even about you. It's bigger than you. Number one, nigga, you can't tell somebody to fall the fuck back on somebody.
And see, dare I say, Rude is probably one of those guys that will come see you. If you notice that, what's this guy's name? Gotti? Bullets Gotti don't come around very much. Because he's a marked man. Anything he says now can and will be held against him. And the same thing with you, angry man. Folks tired of hearing that slogan, catch a flight. So much so that somebody made an anthem out of the angry man flights. Catch a flight. I got them plane tickets. I got them plane tickets. All over you. So again, what kind of content you got? Where's your content? Have you done anything other than talk shit about the war in Ukraine? Have you done anything, talk anything about the price of a loaf of bread? Or have you just referred to gas prices as damn them shit's high? And you ain't by driving nowhere, to be quite honest with you, because ain't no way in hell you can tell you're driving in a parking lot or sitting up on the stream for 3-4 hours at a pop. You can't do me too much driving anyway. So, when's the last time you talked about Trump? He was a Trump supporter, huh? You coming to find out that this was a demon in disguise. If you go way, way back to 2015, before Trump got into office, and the night that we found in 2016 that we found that Trump was going to win the election. And then when Trump put his cabinet together, you go back to my stream, right around that time when Trump took office in 2016, I guarantee you, wherever it was, 2016, yeah, 2016, I guarantee you hear a stream me saying, Trump is organizing a coup. And that's exactly what he did from day one. When he put all those heads of state, all those people in power, they were old white men with money. You backed that kind of shit. You was making fun talking about Trump is going to kick these black women off welfare. He's going to kick these strags off of welfare. BGS talking about the world going to be your oyster when Trump is in office. Black women gonna have to get up off their ass and go to work like they weren't already getting up and going to work. But this was the rhetoric that guys like you and BGS and a whole bunch of these other Kevin Samuels was putting out there. I don't understand it.
Fall the fuck back, nigga. Let you run this goddamn shit without your fat, funny built ass up here, nigga, trying to act like you cool with everybody, and you come in trying to be the voice of reason and shit. Bitch, when you run this fucking game, nigga. Get your 40-plus year old still wearing fitted cap, face head ass, the fuck about here, going about your business, nigga. This ain't your goddamn channel, pussy. This ain't your motherfucking channel, pussy. I. You front of your teenage ass fucking nigga.
Fall back, nigga.
Shut the fuck up, bitch.
Ass nigga.
Ain't no chip on my goddamn shoulder about you, nigga, but I'm gonna dress your whole ass, nigga, when I see you doing the same thing. You tried it with DJ Cooler, nigga, back in 2020, bro. The shit didn't work. Ass. This nigga don't need you helping him, nigga, on no shit like this, nigga. It's between these women, bro. They buy you money and Sheila E, nigga, do their thing. They been doing this shit already. I ain't before you, nigga. So you come in like as your. Like you offering solutions and shit, nigga. You ain't got that.
Don't tell Angryman to do something. When you say.
I know, I'm telling Angryman to fall the fuck back on this one, right? I'm telling Angryman to fall the fuck back on this one, nigga. I'm telling this bitch ass nigga to fall the fuck back. Sheila E. Miss Sheila, we got you, Miss Sheila. Let me and this nigga go.
No, he absolutely, Miss Sheila. No, he is absolutely not wrong. And it's about sometime address somebody. Somebody need to address that head on to Angryman on a panel. And I'm glad there was several other people on this stream so they could he could address that, because this is exactly what he was doing. This is exactly what he does. Like Raw B. Raw B's channel is up and coming. Raw B's doing all these great things. She has all these great attributes on her channel. She's all these different gizmos and gadgets where things are flying around her channel. Eye catching, eye candy stuff. That's what Angryman is after, Raw B. My sister, please don't fall trapped to this shit. I'm begging you. No, I'm not begging you. Do what you want to do, but I'm asking you. All the glitter ain't gold. You don't need Angryman subs. You don't want your shit to turn it. You don't want your stream to turn into a shit show. After a month of the Angryman hanging around you, Raw B, who is going to take you seriously after you start talking about your son that has autism? And why I can say that, that's why I can tell myself, who's going to take me seriously on a stream when I start talking about my son that has autism? Who would take me seriously if night after night after night I got on stream after stream after stream telling black women how ain't shit they are? Who would take me seriously about whether I gave a fuck about my community, whether I gave a fuck about young black boys? Don't fall for it, miss. Just like he did DJ Kuda's channel, and just like he tried to do the Aunt Pete T's channel, he's going to destroy you. Don't fall for it. Ask Kendra D. Ask Kendra D what he did. Ask Char Willie what he did. Ask Cerulean Gray what he did. Ask BGS what he did. Ask Classic Ruby what he did. That's just to name a few names. That's popular in the YouTube streets and the circles that we roll around. Ask them what he did. See if they don't tell you the truth.
I'm not wrong on this one, though, babe. This whole ass nigga right here, he in the motherfucking way, babe. I ain't never dropped you down off my shit, Miss Sheila. You lying out. I done let you get at it with anybody on my shit. Yeah, you know that.
Because I'm right, wasn't out of mind. You dropped me down.
Listen what I'm saying to you, Miss Sheila. I've never dropped you down. You've been able to dress anybody you want to dress on my panel many times.
See all the disrespect you got for women? Caping ass nigga.
I got respect for everybody though, nigga, but I'm not going to get in the way, nigga, when they going at it, nigga. Like, you in the way.
Say, man, like I say, niggas like.
Now, let that make sense just now. See how much respect you got for women? Caping ass nigga, which one is it? Either you are having respect for niggas or you caping or you capping for a woman. Which one? If you got respect for a woman, you capping for them. If you disrespecting a woman, you ain't shit. Which one is it, Angryman? You can't have it both ways, bro. Stop straddling the fence. Stop using the shit when it benefits you. Because that's what you're doing right now. Deflection. Deflection denied. Objection overruled. Order in the goddamn courtroom.
The deflect, man. Now look, I show respect to people who show respect to me, man. All right, that's how it goes, right? I know a lot of folks don't like that. Some folks want to be able to disrespect you, and you still give them the utmost respect. Nigga, I adjust to anybody, man. You got people on here I would never raise my voice to, yell at, curse out, or none of that shit. And you got folks who you seen me, nigga, go at it with, nigga, and got real dirty with their ass, dog, because I adjust to how they came at me. You can't name not one person.
And again, Rue, Angryman, I would have to agree with Rue on this one again. I was on a panel with Rue. We had words. We didn't have words of screaming and yelling. That man spoke to me in a normal tone. Hey, music, let me holler at you for a second. Remember that, Rue? Regardless of the content, he's absolutely right what he says. He addressed people as they address him. If you come at him with the smoke, he coming at you with the smoke. But Angryman, in your case, you come at everybody with the smoke that don't agree with you. Sooner or later, I guarantee if I let this play long enough, you will be talking about catch a flight. But here we go.
You're saying, what are the female hyenas doing? Well, one of the things they did is they got one of their own in the Supreme Court. That's one of the things they did. And if you think for one second that that little development is not going to cause a problem for us moving forward, you've lost your rabbit ass mind. But this is the result. This is the result of having Joe Biden as president.
This is a nigga that just now, I don't know what day this was recorded, but this was some years ago. So you heard this just now. This was recorded this year, what we look into on the screen. Just told Rue that he has no respect for women. And here it is. He's talking about one of the greatest historical moments in the history of the United States. He reduced it to a black woman. He reduced it to a black woman is going to destroy shit because of who? Joe Biden. Let that sink in. But this is the guy that tells you he has content. This is the guy that'll tell you he has content. Yes, it is. Let's go.
Person, no one man or one woman who've always showed me respect, man. That I done really got out of line with on some fuck you, you bitch, you hoe ass nigga, fuck you, you lame ass, cunt ass, hoe, whatever the fuck, right? Whatever the fuck I be saying, right? Nigga, I slap a shot at you, nigga. Bitch, I backhand the fuck out you, nigga. Like, name me one person who've always showed me the utmost respect. And I then came at them in that type of way. We're not talking about somebody who got a soft voice, but they playing dirty, man. We ain't talking about that shit. No, we talking about it's always been, hey, what's up, Rue? Hey, what's up with you, bro? You all right? And I'm just want to just cuss him the fuck out and really just get down with their ass like that, bro. You can't name one person. So when niggas try to deflect, right, in the case of me and Miss Sheila, right, Sheila E ain't never disrespected me. She done talked a little shit, man, but they ain't never been to the point where I got to curse her out, man. Like, she ain't never cursed at me or cuss. You know, she talked her shit when I'd have been on her panel and she done got on my ass and shit, but it never was on no level to where I gotta come at her like that, right? So I can give her the respect to call her Miss Sheila. Hell, that's what this nigga up here doing, calling her Miss Sheila. So when niggas start saying, bro, you caping, bro, like that. This shit is old, man. What I'm saying, bro, use that with new people in the space, nigga, who this shit might affect. This shit do not affect people who've been in the game 3, 4, 5 years, 6 years on YouTube, and they've been knowing other people, been involved in these conversations, bro. That shit does not work, nigga, with us. That shit is numb. We feel numb to anything a nigga saying about us, bro. Like,
facts. Nigga, that shit don't work, bro. Tell him again. That shit don't work. Come at something, of course, something else with you capping for the women or you a simp. That shit don't work with me because I know. Listen, I hate to quote Madea, but they call you and you answer what they call you. What she say? Ain't what they call you. It's what you answer to. You can call me a simp all you want to, nigga. You ain't talking about me. Somebody else in the room. Fuck you talking about? I ain't answer what the fuck. Why would I need to have a conversation about you? The fuck wrong with you? And Rue is absolutely right. I've never seen him just jump on somebody for no fucking reason. Even with some of the harshest shit that some of you folks have said about this man. Hey, but Angryman, you know, your shit, whereas, you know, Rue gets what he gets. Your shit is a combination of trying to be something that you're not. You don't hear this man that's on the other side of the speaker from you. You don't hear him trying to say he's this and he's that. You don't hear none of that. You don't hear him being braggadocious. You don't hear him talking about and joking it in passing. He might think he a ladies' man, or he might get on the panel trying to scoop up one of these chicks. Ain't nothing wrong with that. But you, when you said you had a 98% success rate, come on, bro. I know more about you than you think. I know more about you than you think. If you had 98% success rate, why are you doing a repeat performance where you at? Get what I'm saying? Some folks understand exactly what I'm talking about. If you had a 98% success rate with the woman, with the women's, why are you doing a repeat performance where you're at right now?
You say things like, you caping, you sipping. Stop. Just stop there, bro, because you're not going to shame nobody with that. Nigga, I'm shameless when it comes to that kind of shit. Once again, my point was to tell this fat motherfucking Guatemalan looking ass nigga, that's what he looked like. If you type in Guatemalan women, yeah, the black Guatemalans, nigga, he look like he from Guatemala City and shit. The nigga like he's a breastfeeding Guatemalan. He ain't just breastfeeding his own babies, nigga. He breastfeeding the babies in the village looking ass Guatemalan, nigga. Why he eat bananas? Told that nigga, get the fuck out of this shit, bro. Not because nigga want to see these women go at it. Nah, it's more like they trying to address some shit. And they don't want nobody in their fucking way. Because I know how I feel if I'm trying to get at a nigga ass and somebody telling me, hey, Rue, bro. Rue. Hey, Rue. But look, listen, Rue. And I'm trying to get at this motherfucking nigga. Or he's getting at me. Or he done said some shit to me. Or did some shit to me, bro. So I want to get on this nigga head, bro. And you got somebody talking about Rue. Somebody other than the host. Mind you, somebody other than the host is in the middle of this shit. What are you doing, man? So you talk about all this when everybody pretty much get tired, nigga. You out of breath, and now the panel's kind of quiet and shit, and now you can't come in with your intervention, I guess, right? Not when the motherfucking shit's hot. That's like being in between two niggas shooting at each other, bro. Nah, you got to come in when them bodies on the ground and the motherfucker's still alive, man. Try to rush a nigga to the hospital or something. But you're not getting in between the shootout, man. I'm not getting in between niggas bussing. Nah, bro. Nah, man. Listen, man.
You in the motherfucking way, man.
You put me in bed. You had bodies all up jump on me, bro. You's a liar.
No, I didn't have nobody jumping on you, man. You had your chance to fight like you was fighting. I didn't mute you or none of that shit.
Angryman, you come in with me like that, bro. You's a liar.
You come over here with that bullshit.
Angryman,
say, man, shut the fuck up talking to me, nigga. What the fuck, nigga? Stop dumb ass up talking to me, man. Hey,
fuck.
Hey, you farted. You farted your own teenager, nigga. Hey, you farted wearing feeder cap, nigga. You ain't going to no motherfucking game. You ain't going to no baseball game or none of that shit. Hey, hey, I don't want to hear nothing from a nigga named.
I ain't trying to hear nothing from a nigga having midlife crisis, man. Like I said, I might have my midlife crisis one day, man. And I think my midlife crisis might be me having another baby, dog. As a matter of fact, dog, since we want to get into it, right? So I'm not against a nigga, you know, having a midlife crisis, dog. But it's not going to be me dressing like I'm T.K. Kirkland and shit. Yeah, y'all type in T.K. Kirkland, right? Hold on, let me type it in right fast. Hold on. Let me do a little brief, you know, take a little break and shit, man. I want y'all to look at this shit right here, right? This P-Gay, right? P-Gay. I want y'all to look at this shit. It's not going to be me, man. I ain't going to baby do it. Here you go. Y'all hold on for a second. Hold up. I just gotta kind of shatter this shit, man. This Angryman vibe. This Angryman vibe right here, man. This it right here. This your boy Angryman right here. Look, I'm not gonna be on no shit like this. This nigga 60 years old, bro. I'm not saying anything wrong wearing a fitted, nigga, but shit. Not a part of your everyday wardrobe, man, to where you purposely, right? Trying to hide the fact that you 60. Now, I know we hip-hop generation. We'll get tattoos while we 50 and 60 and all that, right? But
now, you got guys running around here bragging about the fact that Joe Biden won. And I'm trying to figure out in my mind, how are you bragging about Joe Biden winning when him winning is to your detriment? How much did you have to put in your gas tank last time? You know what? My girl told me that Walmart is running out of bicycles because people are buying bikes because they cannot afford to put gas in their car. This is the funny thing about it. The funny thing about it is you got guys running around here coming to me talking about some, oh, you think you right about everything, Angry Man, but you was the one that was saying that Trump was going to win. You was wrong about that. Okay. Okay, so Joe Biden is your president. So you got bragging rights to say that you were right. But you broke. You can't even put gas in your freaking car, but you're talking about me. I can put gas in my car. And guess what? I don't even have to put gas in my car. I could sit right here all day, every day, and drop videos. I don't got to go nowhere.
You heard it for yourself. I can sit here all day, every day. What, as Rue said, what 40-year-old man sits somewhere in a spot all day, drop videos, and said this is his living? You ain't doing that much. According to what you said from Kevin Samuels, you ain't doing that much. You ain't living like that. GMT has your history, Angry Man. So we know what you're saying now is not absolutely true. If it had not been for YouTube, you better go find a job. Y'all heard it. Y'all heard it. That's right.
Where to make money. You got to go nowhere. So how does it benefit you to talk about me being wrong and leave out the part that I also said? Don't forget that I also said that I hope that Joe Biden wins so I can prove how stupid a lot of you are. Mission accomplished. Because he is the worst president to ever exist in the history of this country.
Yeah. Well, explain to me why everything about Donald Trump, including his family, is corrupt. Explain to me why right now that Donald Trump has all kinds of different lawsuits pending everywhere. Explain to me why Donald Trump took Pentagon information to his house. Explain to me why now we have written proof, we have visual proof, we have verbal proof that Donald Trump committed treason against the United States of America. So what apart from that makes Biden the worst president ever? Damn the high gas prices. There's a whole lot more entangled to that, but if you were a good content creator, if you wasn't basing your shows on rhetoric and bullshit, you would go and do your research to know that everything is up. It's just not the price of gas, because as it stands, we only import 8% of our oil from Russia. The majority of the other countries is where they get their fossil fuels from. Russia. 15%, 20%. The problem is not the gas. It's the price of a loaf of bread right now, my man. Because we export more wheat. It's export than we import. So that means the price of bread is now going up. So that means that instead of the price of, I'll take for instance, the price of Arizona iced tea. A couple years ago used to be 99 cents. It's a father and son company owned business. They choose, they're worth billions and millions of dollars. Billions of dollars. You think to keep it at 99 cents would hurt them? Durst Baking Company. You would think it would hurt them to drop the price of bread down to $1.29? No. It would not bother them, would not hurt their profits. So, again, what part of being a content creator are you? I'll ask you.
It's undisputable. Nobody can even dispute that at this point. Who can dispute that at this point? Can anyone dispute that at this point?
I just did. Shut the fuck up.
Can anyone dispute that? I said it.
I just did it.
I said, and you know what? Here's the funny thing.
What?
The funny thing is,
what?
I was right.
No, you wasn't right
on both
counts. No, you wasn't. You was absolutely wrong on both counts.
Trump was going to win?
No.
I was right about
that. Trump didn't win. The fuck?
When I
did y'all hear
said that?
That?
I hope Joe Biden wins so I can prove how stupid y'all are.
Amen.
I was right about that, too.
How the fuck did that happen? How did you just tell me Trump win and Biden won? You're part of that conspiracy theory. You see what I'm saying, folks? You got to understand sometime what motherfuckers say just to be talking. You got to catch the little subtle nuances of what folks say. Be a wordsmith. Don't take everything that a motherfucker tells you as verbatim and gospel. The fuck? He just said in the same breath that two presidents won that last election. I told you Trump was going to win. How? Was it a slip of the tongue? No. Should he have said, I told you Trump was going to lose? No, he told us Trump was going to win. Then he says, and I knew Biden was going to win. Which one was it? And I'm glad he won so I could prove you niggas. Shut the fuck up. The fuck?
I actually was right about everything. I actually, and anybody who has watched my content the entire time, anybody that has watched my content the entire time, right? You know everything I've said has come to pass. Everything.
You damn Skippy. In the opposite
time.
In the opposite fucking direction.
Anybody that has watched my content the entire time, right? You know everything I've said has come to pass.
You're an idiot.
Everything.
You're an absolute idiot.
And don't sit here and say, oh, you said Trump was going to win. Stop acting like they wasn't disputing all of that shit.
See what I'm saying?
Stop acting like that.
See what I'm saying?
Stop acting like that.
You see what I'm saying, folks?
Stop acting like that.
See what I'm saying,
because
folks?
At the end of the day, Clarence Thomas and Alito was going to see that case.
See what I'm saying, folks?
Okay?
See what I'm saying?
But Chief Justice Roberts would not see it. You know why? Because Chief Justice Roberts hates Donald Trump.
And that would be the reason that you don't listen to this motherfucker right here when he starts talking about politics. First and foremost, Judge Clarence Thomas, we now know, should have reclused himself due to the antics of his wife. It was not an 8 to 7 to 2 dissension. There was an 8 to 1. The only dissenting judge that was against the January 6th commission was Judge Clarence Thomas. Why? Because Judge Clarence Thomas's wife was in cahoots with these insurrectionists. And it is proven. So, Angryman, shut the fuck up when you don't know what you're talking about. You're a content creator, right? That tells me this, that you have nothing else better to do than to disrupt your own opinions. There's nothing about your content that's fact-based, except, wait a minute, I got something here for you. Last night, you were talking about what it is to be, how to teach a child to be a man, and specifically a young boy. This is what you got to do. It didn't, not too much of the conversation made any sense to me as I was listening to it. I wanted to see what angle. Well, maybe I was wrong about the guy. But I wasn't. And the reason why I say that I wasn't is because, again, remember, some of the things that you say can and will be used against you. Now, am I the perfect dad? Am I the perfect father? By no stretch of the imagination, am I? Am I? We all make mistakes. We all have done things that we regret when it comes to our children. We all have said things to our children that may right regret. We might have been a little harsh to them. We might allow them not to do something that was beneficial based on our own way of thinking. We might not have spent a whole bunch of time with them. We might have spent no time with them. We might have never told them we loved them. There's several things that parents can do to lose favor with their children. It was absolutely in my days of coming up, I revered my mother and my father. They could do no wrong in my eyes. Absolutely nothing. Right, wrong, or indifferent. My mother and my father, till the day they passed, could do no wrong. But you, my man, I want you to take a listen to this clip here first.
I have that issue with my second oldest son.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
My second oldest son, I've had all kinds of little problems with him. Last year in the summertime, we had a little issue.
Mm-hmm.
And I send him back to his mother.
Mm.
According to that stream that you had last night, why would you send your man child to a woman? Did you not watch Boys in the Hood, nigga? At a certain age, there is absolutely nothing a woman can teach a boy about being a man. And from what I understand, this was at that time that even though that the son didn't live with you, the mother sent him to you for some reason or the other. Maybe he was unruly with her, or maybe he wanted to see what it was living with his dad, what it was like living with his dad. It's obvious that you had the accommodations for it. But you said you had to send him back. Now, according to your stream last night, isn't that the wrong thing to do? Wasn't that the wrong thing to do? Wait, let me pull it up. Because I just happened to grab part of the stream that you did last night. Okay? Here we go. Let me go and find it right quick. Like, matter of fact, let me let you listen to this while I go and pull up some more of this stream.
It is mine, right? And, you know, I kind of had to give him the cold shoulder, kind of loving from a distance, you know. And he's finally got to the point where he's like, okay, I understand what I did wrong.
Mm.
Took him almost a year.
Wow. Okay. And then what? The brainwashing is deep.
Yeah, like he was, you know, he was here. Well, in the last apartment that I had, he was being super disrespectful, not appreciating.
I remember that.
Yeah,
he steadily had to keep a foot off of his mind.
Yeah, he was being super disrespectful, and it kind of reached its peak one day where I had to put hands on him.
Mm.
Y'all heard it for yourself. I don't know if that's in there. That sounds like the Game Changer in BGS. An angry man, and you hear it clearly that he had troubles with his son, and it ended up that all else failed, that he literally put his hands on his son. After he put hands on his son, he decided, you know what, I'm gonna send him back to his mama to get his mind right. Do you think your son is gonna ever forget that you fought him, not as, you didn't punish him as dad, you fought him as adversary, angry man? And this is what you said on a live stream. Take it back then, you ain't had no beard, huh? What happened to all this masculine mercenary shit, by the way? What happened to all of that? We We're going to get to that, too. I know the stream is going to be kind of long, folks. I told you. I got so much material. I could talk about Angryman 3 hours a damn day. But there's no need in that. I'm going to do one or two more of these streams, and enough will be enough. This is part one of the 3-hour series, the 9-hour mini series, or whatever long mini series, okay? But Angryman, come on, bro. You putting hands on your son for what? Because he was being disrespectful. So how far did the argument escalate? How loud did it get? Guarantee the police came.
Yeah, wow. Okay.
So you had Tariq like all over the table at that moment.
I had Tariq up in here. The only difference between me and James is I wasn't gonna wait until it turned into a monster. I showed my, you know what I'm saying, I showed my force. Like, look, this is how I go down. Like, I'm not playing these games with you. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, he's still who he is.
Right.
Because just like Ghost, you know what I'm saying, Tariq has Ghost in him, he has me in him. So I know why he acts that way, I know why he operates that way, but a lot.
So, let me make this sense. He says he has a lot of me in him. So that should make it more understanding to you why the young man acts out. So are you saying he has the more violent side of you? And that was the only way that you could get through to him, through violence? Is that the only way that we can get through to you? Is somebody choking your ass out? Is somebody physically putting hands on you to get their point across? Or is that why you are on these streams, grabbing the microphone, hollering, catch a flight? Is that why your son being disrespectful? Because this is what he heard night in and night out. You being a tough guy on the internet. You doing these streams night after night after night instead of spending time with him. You on the computer all damn day. Maybe that's why your son was acting out. I didn't come here for this. I came here to be with Pops. But instead, I got to hang out with the step folks. Because my Pops ain't got time for me. He doing a live stream. Y'all be quiet.
Of it has been fueled by his mom.
Right.
And then on top of that, what you do, Angryman? You're blaming on us. What about, like Dre says, what about them black baby mamas? What about them baby mamas? And see, again, Angryman, I know a lot about you. I understand your son is a fledgling rapper. Why don't we have any of his material on your websites or any of his material in your live streams? If my sons did music or if my sons were good enough, and I would promote them. Just like my nieces, I promote them. I have some nieces that can sing. I have some nieces that work with John Legend, that's done other things in the music industry. And I do play their music on my radio station because they are that good. Until this information was passed to me, I had no idea that one of your sons was in the music industry or attempting to be in the music industry. And I got to say, from what I heard, with the right teachings and the right amount, and when he get to that 10,000 hours of practice, he might have something. But he damn sure ain't getting it from you, because you on live streams. If that's the same son we talking about. Picture that. What a man, what a man, what a fucked up man. Come on, I got some more shit for you. Listen to what, this is what you were talking about last night. Check this out. This was you last night. This was you last night talking about what it takes to be a man. This was you.
Let me stop you right there, bro. Let me stop you right there. Were you getting ready to say that the woman might look at your frugalness and say that he might be a good man, he's just trying to be frugal.
No, no, that's not frugal. I'm saying she might think that I ain't nothing because I took on a coffee date, or she might think, you know what, we probably doing this to see if we compatible, and then if she see if we are compatible, ask out again, she say yeah, and she see I took her somewhere even nicer, she realize, okay, all right, he must see me as a good woman because that's what I showed on the
shout out to Drew's World. He said, let's just admit that most of these dudes are broke, so they penny pinch. That's possible. Shout out to Ray Clemens. He said, a good wholesome woman ain't accepting a goofy ass coffee date. That's her shit test.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yes. Yes, they know that y'all do that.
No. Hell no. Ace to the Izzo. Hell to the no. Back in the day, folks, you could not get a date. I'm not talking about doing my day. I'm talking about since forever. Remember, you had to go to the... There wasn't no such thing as pulling up to the whatchamacallit, blowing the horn. There wasn't no such thing as Instagram and these meetup sites, Bumble and all these other stuff. There was no back chats and none of that. If you was interested in a young lady back in the 70s and the 80s, and even so much into some places in the 90s, you had to go through pops first. You had to get acquainted with the folks around her. And you usually started off, number one, hey, let's, it depends on what type of person you are. So to go sit down at a coffee shop and have a cup of coffee with a woman and have conversation with her, and let's see where the evening starts at. But why not let the evening start with coffee? Because if she is a smart woman, if she's a wholesome woman, she's not going to meet you at no derelict place. She's not going, hey, let's meet up at the whole spot. Oh, you know where so-and-so is on Cumberland Mall Boulevard? Yeah, I do. It's a nice little quaint little coffee shop. Let's meet over there. All right, cool. You find out over coffee, y'all like each other. Hey, this was nice little, I really don't want the date to end. It's still early. What's playing on the movies? One thing leads to another. If you have that chemistry, if you have that conversation, so far on this first date, nothing about the money's come up. How much you make? I mean, all this other stuff. Yeah, you might. What you doing? What you dive do? But you don't know whether she broke. He don't know whether you broke. I hope as a grown man, you're not going on no date with no $10 in your pocket. I hope that's not what you're doing. But this is the kind of advice that you're getting from dudes like this over here. Let's go. The fuck, angry man.
Y'all, do you guys think that you're the only ones that can read those PUA books? Y'all do know women can read, right?
Of course. I mean, they hit me like y'all.
Hold up, nigga. I don't need to read no PUA. I don't need to need no pickup artist book. That's the thing right there. What you reading them for? Fuck, you're right. Who you think these pickup artists is getting the information from? Women. The fuck, I need to pay you to write something down in a book for me to go read it when I just can sit and observe and see and hear what women saying them for themselves. Remember the back in the day that the big I don't look at it much no more, but Cosmopolitan, Vogue, and all these other magazines before there was the internet, all that other stuff. And Ebony magazine, there was always a column in there about women's thoughts, women's ideas, and all that. That's how I got my information about women. In their books. Need no pickup artist. $59.99, and I'll get you any date you want. Hell no. No thank you. $59.99, I can go buy me what I want. fuck I need you for?
I do know that guys have been doing that coffee date shit since 2005, right? And it's now 2020. It's 2022. Dudes have been doing that since 2005.
There you go. That tells you a guy that absolutely don't know what he talks about. No, dudes have been doing that forever. The coffee shit just didn't start, man. We was doing the coffee shit back in the 80s. They was doing the coffee shit in the 70s. As far as I can remember back to folks that started dating, because my older brothers started dating in the 70s. Late 70s. So I know it was some of the characteristics of dating in the 70s had to roll over into the 80s and the 90s, man. So what the fuck are you talking about? There wouldn't be no internet cafes, no coffee shops if men and women didn't meet up in these places. What the fuck are you talking about? You mean to tell me you think coffee shops did start existing in 2005? Wait a minute. I got something for you on that. Hold up. Let me go and get something for you on that shit right there. Wait a minute. Do you really think, I'm asking you again, do you really think coffee shops start existing in 2005? The coffee date? Here. There you go. The fuck? That is absolutely crazy. But let's go.
Okay. Well,
that tactic was actually in Neil Strauss's book, The Game. And that book came out in 2005, if I'm not mistaken.
It just goes to show you, that's how far he went back into the dating arena to get his information. 2005, add it up. It is 2022. 2005, 2015, that's 10 years, right? It's 2022. We ain't in 2025 yet. So he going back and grabbing less than 20 years of dating experience trying to tell you folks, trying to quote a motherfucker who ain't been on the planet that long. They just started writing books in 2005. That's where he dug back to. 2005. Neil Strauss. The pickup artist, not realizing that what those movies in the 80s, that's where Neil Strauss got his ideas from. Remember Jeff Spicoli? Fast Times at Ridgemont High? That came out in the 80s, bro. Stop it.
So see, here's the thing. Here's the thing, and this is where the problem comes in. The problem comes in where you guys always approach the dating world as if the woman is a SCRAGG. That's how you guys initially approach the dating world, is you approach it under the assumption that the woman ain't shit.
No. Remember earlier, he says the women are laid back and relaxed and who they are because he has not been cooking. So the women feel a little bit more comfortable because he has stopped cooking. He hadn't reached in and pulled out the inner strength. That's in all of them. This is the guy that you niggas is taking dating advice from. Not my words. His own words. You got a fisherman's cap on and a polo sports shirt on trying to tell niggas how to catch a woman. Nothing about this stream I heard last night is useful. Again, Angry Man, I ask you, where your content at, bro? Where your content at, man?
Oh, really? Yes. Because if you approached it you're approaching it from a pessimistic standpoint. You're approaching it from the cup being half full, half empty instead of half full. Because if you was approaching it from the standpoint that she might be a good woman, you wouldn't give a fuck about what type of fucking, you wouldn't give a damn about going on a regular date.
Well, can I ask you this, big bro?
Go ahead.
So, do you think, I heard you and other guys say, like, you know, the woman has to earn certain things.
I got confused. Let me go back.
Fucking, you wouldn't give a damn about going on a regular date. You're approaching it from a pessimistic standpoint. You're approaching it from the cup being half full, half empty instead of half full. Because if you was approaching it from the standpoint that she might be a good woman, you wouldn't give a fuck about what type of fucking, you wouldn't give a damn about going on a regular date.
Well, can I ask you this, big bro?
Go ahead.
Okay. I'm still kind of confused about what the hell he was saying just now. So, what I'm saying is, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I call me old-fashioned. But, you know, not unless you got hooked up on a blind date, you generally know the person or something, a little bit of something about the person that you're about to go on a date with. Because that's what we're talking about now. We're not talking about one-night stands. You're meeting somebody in the club. We're talking about dating. You met somebody on an app somewhere. Y'all start a conversation via whatever apps is available. Y'all start to FaceTiming each other. Y'all start talking to each other. Finally, you get up and you know what? Let's meet at a coffee shop. Now you got that face-to-face interaction, okay? The interaction that we had on the phone is the same interaction that we have in here. Let's move it on. Long before you came on that date, chances are you had already at some point you had decided, well, this is a good enough woman for me to at least attempt to go on a date with, at least to find out more about her. What kind of feelings I have about her yet, I don't know. But I'm willing to go explore and find out. I'm not going to reach up and see if I can pull out her inner SCRAGG to prove that I'm right. Because you know all women got it in them. According to this dating coach, the Angryman. Now, you was about to ask him what, young blood? I didn't mean to stop you, but I had to get in on that one. What was you about to say?
So, do you think, I heard you and other guys say, like, you know, the woman has to earn certain things from you. Don't give her everything at once. She has to earn that, you know what I mean? So you can't just, like, just give her the whole thing.
Bruh, check this out. If taking her to dinner and a movie in your mind is giving her everything at once, I don't know what to tell you, bro. It's dinner and a movie.
Again, folks, if you go back to the Angryman's shows and his comments, don't you do nothing for them SCRAGGs. Don't buy them nothing. I'm this, I'm that. When I go on a date, hey, you know, this is what this guy is saying. So, which is an Angryman? Do you pull the chair out for the chick? Do you open the car door for her? Or do you make her pay for the date? Which is it? What you do? I'm confused by this dating advice that you're giving out right now. It don't make sense.
It's dinner in a fucking movie, bro. That is not no heavy shit. That is not nothing fucking serious. But let me ask you this question.
What?
Let's say you got a homeboy, right?
Right.
And let's say that you and your homeboy was fucking hanging out and shit, right?
Right.
Two of y'all go to a fucking club and shit.
Right.
And y'all at the bar. And you're like, yo, fam, don't even worry about it. I got you. I'm gonna buy the drinks. We good. And you spend $100 on drinks, right?
Right.
Your homeboy definitely ain't giving you no cooch later because he ain't got no cooch to give you.
Now, what kind of analogy were you trying to drum up? If I hang out with my boys, and I'm telling my boys, that's already established before we get to the spot. Yo, man, dude, Man, you in some cases, yo, you just getting out the joint. Or, man, we celebrating tonight, bro. Hey, your money ain't no good tonight, partner. So how do you draw a conclusion to what he just asked you? How do you draw a comparison to hanging out with your boys, belly up to the bar fellas, and buying drinks on a date with a woman? Of course you're not putting everything up front. Did you bring the kitchen sink with you? Did you hand her the keys to your car? Did you give her the deed to your house when y'all went on that first date? Of course not. And I agree with this part of it. It's just dinner and a movie, bro. It ain't that serious. You're trying to find out whether you want to be with this chick. Is there going to be a second dinner in the movie? To be quite honest with you, in some cases, some of us might think, yeah, but when you called her back, she's like, no. I ain't feeling it. So what kind of advice is this cat giving y'all, man?
Do you feel like you got played?
Well, no, because that's another. Well, first of all, I don't look at him as my mate. He's my homeboy.
Right. What the fuck?
At the end of the day, whether he's your homeboy or a date, you're spending time and you're spending.
See, this is what I'm talking about. When these so-called internet gurus try to make sense of their talking points, in this case, so-called talking points. No, it's a whole different scenario. When I'm hanging out with my boys, I ain't spending time. That's some shit my chick would say when she mad at me. Out there spending time with your boys and ain't spending no time with me. That would be some shit that my girl would say. And I'm not looking back at my wallet and say, damn, man, I spent all that money on that nigga. I'm gonna get something. The fuck?
Money. So what separates the two between the woman and the dude? What separates those two situations?
The difference is, you know, like I said, I'm dealing with him on some homeboy stuff. I'm dealing with her on some intimate, see if me and her can be possibly, I'm going to say it, we can be a couple in the future. So.
And I'm glad I didn't have to answer that. Thank God I did not have to answer that. God damn, I'm glad y'all said it all. Used to be hard, now you're just wet and soft. We thought you was down with the AK. But I saw you in a video with Raw B yesterday. Come on, angry man. Stop giving up relationship advice because you suck at it. Stop trying to be the internet guru about everything because you suck at it. I don't give up marriage advice because I'm divorced. Only thing I can tell you is what not to do.
So in other words, because you beating around the bush, I'm going to tell you what the difference is. The difference is when you spend money on a woman, you expect her to fuck you after. That's the difference.
Not true. Not every date I went on that I took a young woman out, I was expecting some pussy after that. That just shows you the mentality of said niggas. That shows you the mentality of said niggas. But you sitting up here trying to what's the name of your stream? What's the name of it? How do we get men to turn men back into men? Whatever the fuck the name of that stream was. How the fuck?
That's the difference. And that's the reason why a lot of you guys have the difficulty you have, because guess what? When you deal with women, you display nonverbal communication. She knows that. And that's okay. That right there is the reason why a lot of times women don't give you none at the end of the fucking date, because they know that's what you did the shit for. But see, here's the thing. Guys that are alphas, guys that are ladies' men, they go out to have a good time, no matter what the circumstances is. And you see this a lot in white boys. White boys will be at a club
and they'll be in there having a good time, and they'll be like, hey, dude, what you drinking? I'm buying everybody drinks. Ain't tripping about that shit.
So if that's the case, Angryman, why would you ask this brother earlier that very same question? If you know that's what the white boys do, what the brothers can't do though, without some kind of expectation? Is it the white dude considering spending time with his dudes? Is the white dude going to be mad? You see what I'm saying? You don't make sense. Nothing that you say makes sense. You're hyperbolic with your bullshit. It's just watered down versions of Kevin Samuels. Trying to be an internet guru, trying to be a relationship expert, and you are not.
Okay. Ain't tripping about that shit. See, the thing about it is, look, back in the day, the reason why I had so much success with women is because I didn't go into dates expecting something. I never did. I always went on dates because I wanted to have a good fucking time. If I met a chick and then I was like, shit, I ain't doing nothing Friday. What can I do? Shit, there's this movie coming out that I want to see. And I'm definitely going to get something to eat. So I call up a chick that I know, like, yo, you want to go out Friday? And she like, okay, cool. And I'm not, even though I'm gonna dress nice and I'm gonna be smelling good, that's not necessarily to impress the woman. That's just because I know I'm going out somewhere. I'm gonna do that same routine.
Does that make sense? You call up someone, you go on a date. What, you just gonna come in jeans and a damn t-shirt? If you're trying to make an impression on someone, it's obvious. You thought enough about this woman. It's not just, because you can go see a movie by yourself. Come on, folks. You can go see a movie by yourself. You can go get something to eat by yourself. If it's that kind of movie, you can call up one of your boys. Yo, man, so-and-so playing. After that, man, let's stop at the Whopper House. Let's see what we can get up on at the club later on. That's how I did it. Yo, dude, so-and-so, man, hey, man, shit. If the movie ain't popping, bro, man, let's go. Or after the movie is kicked, man, let's go on out to the club and shit like that. See what we can do what's up there, scare up some fun out there. The fuck are you talking about, Angryman? I'm not a relationship expert. I'm just your average, everyday person living their life. If I called up a chick on Monday and I'm making a date for Friday, that means I'm clearing all of my schedule to spend time with her. I booked your time. Of course, I'm going to put on my Sunday go to meeting and my smell good. Get my hair cut. It's called a date. I wish to hell, Angryman, you show up on a date with this on. See if you get a second one.
If I'm just going out to hang out. So I'm not doing it for the woman. I'm doing it because I want to have a good time. And guess what? Because I'm going out to have a good time, I'm not putting off the vibe that I want something from her. I'm putting out the vibe that I'm out having a good time. And because of that, she's going to have a good time, which means she's going to want to do that shit again. Right. And nine times out of ten, I don't mean to put it out here like that, but I'm going to put it out there like that. I have like a 98% close rate, bro. It's been very rare that I went out with a woman and she didn't offer the cooch later. Very rare.
Wow, really?
Yes.
Damn.
Yes. Very rare. In fact, it's so rare that I'm surprised. That whenever I went on dates and then the date ended and it didn't turn into nothing else, I'd be surprised. But I didn't trip about it. I ain't trip about it because I knew like I can't blame her for how her mama raised her. You understand what I'm saying? I can't be mad at her for operating in a way where she wants to respect herself. You feel me? But at the same time, I'm not judging the women who feel free enough in their sexuality to not give a fuck about that first date rule.
There you go. This is the biggest contradiction of anything that you have said, Angryman. This shit right here. Your stream is full of women taking over. The gynocracy this. The women are doing this and the women are doing that. Hell no. Cut these women off. Cut that woman off. Cut that woman off. If she sleep with you, she's sleeping with all the homeboys. If she give it up on the first date, she ain't shit. Y'all heard it for yourself. This man said he had a 98% kill ratio. 98% of the women that he dealt with gave up the coochie, and if they didn't, the other 2%, he was surprised that they didn't give it up. You had that much fucking charm. Well, for that, let me give you the world famous one more time. Thank you. You don't use that no more, do you, Angryman? Since I called you out on using Saru and Gray's voice, huh? Stop using it for your cash app. Haha, picture that. Tell me you don't listen.
You understand? So I'm not judging her either way. If she wants to do that, cool, we can do that. If she don't want to do that, cool, we don't got to do that. Because I know if we keep dealing with each other, eventually she's going to want to do that because I'm offering comfort.
Oh, Lord have mercy. You offering comfort. Sooner or later, just based on the person that you are, you know she gonna won't give it up. Just based on who you are. Well, Angryman, if you date someone long enough, not unless she holds true to the value that I'm not having sex until we get married. Even there's some ladies that say after 6 months, if you're still true and blue, then I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to put a picture of it on my refrigerator. In 6 months, I'm going to come knock on the door. Open up. You know what you said in 6 months. We still know each other. You see what I'm saying, Angryman? So again, for all you folks out there, you aspiring and budding young would-be suitors out there, don't take this nigga's advice. Don't believe that 98% of the time when you see a woman, you're gonna end up in the bedroom. Don't believe that. Not unless she on Pornhub. Don't believe that shit there, or not unless you buy one of them blow-up dolls and stuff her in the closet. Now, that's 100% success ratio. All you got to do is put batteries in her ass. But this shit right here, this man's telling you, oh, no, no, no.
I'm offering a good time. I'm not coming into the situation with a bunch of expectation. I'm not going to be like, oh, she... Yo, we went out and she wanted the lobster, so she definitely got to give up some ass. Like, I'm not, because if that's the case, I might as well be messing with an escort or a renegade.
Okay.
But that's not what I'm looking for. I'm not looking for an escort or a fucking renegade. Is that with the kids nowadays, everything hurts their feelings. Like, everything you say to them hurts their feelings, right?
I wanted to go back to this last part here. Okay, let me pause this. Okay, it's obvious now he's talking about children again. Now, remember, that's why I did not take this particular stream down. Okay, this particular one down here. Listen to this again, okay?
I have that issue with my second oldest son.
Mm-hmm.
My second oldest son, I've had all kinds of little problems with him. Last year in the summertime, we had a little issue.
Mm-hmm.
And I send him back to his mother.
Mm.
Get his mind right. And you know, I kind of had to give him the cold shoulder, kind of love him from a distance, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And he's finally got to the point where he's like, okay, I understand what I did wrong.
Alright. That was the angry man talking about his second oldest son. Now here it is again. Here's the angry man talking about. Listen for yourself.
Everything. You feel me? And it's like, I'm sitting there, you know, I'm having the conversation after I talked to them and got everything situated. I'm having the conversation with my girl and I'm like, how can you teach these younger folk when they're so sensitive? You understand what I'm saying? Shout out to 9-5, he said facts. How can you teach them when they're so sensitive?
His answer was to give him the cold shoulder, to love him from a distance. That was his teaching method. You heard it yourself. I did not say it. I did not make it up. You heard it out of his own mouth. First, he got into an argument. He said his son was being disrespectful. Later on, the disrespect got to the level that he had to put hands on him. Sent him back to his mother. Cut him off. Loved him from a distance. Didn't say anything to him. But the stream was what?
Every little thing you say hurts their feelings. You know, it's like you're having a conversation with one of them. Like earlier, I was having a conversation with their older sister, and I'm trying to explain something to her, and she's just, and I'm like, yo, shut up and listen to what I'm telling you. Why you gotta tell me to shut up? Why are you saying shut up? Like, it's like you can never get to the lesson, because when you're trying to teach them something, everything hurts their feelings.
When you're trying to teach them something, everything hurts their feelings. That's what he said. Not true. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to get up out of here. I got a whole lot more on the angry man. Just make sure you like, share, and subscribe if you don't mind. And we'll be back again with part two of the angry man. In the meantime, make sure you check out my good friend Shar Willie and the Just Ask Shar Advice Channel, Conversations with Shar, tonight on these YouTube streets. Like, share, and subscribe. And here you go. Here's a little commercial for it.
This is Shar Willie from the Just Ask Shar Advice Channel on YouTube. Join me on Friday nights at 9:30 p.m. Central, where we have an open panel giving advice in real time. Come join us. See you soon. You're listening to CRBJ, classic R&B jams, soulful sounds all around town.